Hi, I'm Eric Knorr, Editor-in-Chief of IDG Enterprise, and with me today is Chuck Robbins, CEO of Cisco. A freshman announcement that you described as the biggest announcement in your tenure at Cisco over the past 2 years. And also you said it was going to redefine networking for the next 30 years. What are the implications for the people that read our publications, which are people who are in charge of networking for the enterprise and provision and maintain those networks? What are the implications for them?
First of all, thanks for having me. And if you step back and you look at what we announced today, it truly is a new era of networking, and we're ushering in waves of innovation with what we announced today and giving our customers this ability to build an intuitive network that starts with intent and the programmability. So rewriting the operating system with an API structure so that you can program it, giving our customers then analytics and insights coming out of the network that only the network can see. There's so much data there, right? And giving them that context to help them be more effective. And then obviously driving this new wave of security that we talked about today is just incredibly important. And all of that over time, this new network will continue to adapt and continue to learn, creating an intuitive environment for our customers.
Now today you also announced the introduction of the Catalyst 9000 series. So how much of this new capability will I get with existing hardware versus the new 9000?
Yeah, it's a great question. So we announced the intent portion, so the automation, the DNA center that we announced today, has backwards compatibility. So the automation capability is backwards compatible to a broader set of our portfolio based on running the appropriate operating system. So we did give customers backwards compatibility to make sure that they can derive the value from that. There are some capabilities that are only available because of the high-speed custom silicon that we actually have in the Catalyst 9000. So the encrypted traffic analytics, which was a revolutionary announcement today around our ability to identify malware inside encrypted traffic without decrypting the traffic. That is only available on the new platform because of the speed and the performance that you have to do wire speed analytics without degrading. So it's a bit of both, but we think that it gives our customers the appropriate level of investment protection, but also with the ability to move to some really unique innovation as well.
Okay, and how would you say this announcement dovetails, this may be kind of a complicated question, with your application-centric infrastructure announcement of 2 years ago? That was sort of the last big infrastructure. Do you see this as an extension of this, or how does it lay out as in your long-term plan?
Well, if you think about ACI, what it did is allowed you to deploy policy in the data center.
Right.
This brings automation and policy to the enterprise network, the campus network, the wide area, and over time we will bring those two together so that our enterprise customers can actually have the ability to deploy policy from the data center, through the campus, through their security architecture, all the way to the branch. And so it's very complementary.
Now today you also talked about moving more towards subscriptions. And this is something that Cisco's been talking about a while. What's the difference today? How is that changing for your customers?
Well, what we announced, if you think about what we announced today, it really is helping our customers with a multi-year journey to this new architecture. And it really helps them get to a place where they remove the complexity, drive tremendous scale, solve the security problem. So what we have done is really created some advanced capabilities that are unique and new that we are offering to our customers over the lifetime of the product, and we're allowing them to actually pay for it over the lifetime. Mm-hmm. And what you're going to see from us is this continued ability, because of the new architecture that we built, we can actually continue to offer new services and new capabilities on top of this platform for our customers in the future. So it creates greater long-term value for them, and it also creates a subscription model for us, which obviously our investors like from a predictability perspective.
Great. Well, Chuck, I'd like to thank you so much for talking with us today.
Great. And Eric, thank you. Thanks for having me.